A planter that has a cover on it, and then the cover goes off when you pick it up. Oh man, yes! What's going on, everybody? DJ Goham here. Welcome back to the channel and welcome to new mods for Farming Simulator 19. Today I got 13 mods for you. For all platforms, we've got 4 new and 1 update. And PC and Mac, we've got 7 new and 1 update. Let's check it out. First up today, new mods for all platforms. We have the Compact BP503L. This is a Valtra. Yes, this is a Valtra seeder, or planter rather. Sorry. Yes, it's a planter, so it does corn, sunflower, soybeans. It also do sugar beets and cotton. Costs $25,000, holds 700 liters of seed and fertilizer, has a 70 horsepower requirement. It goes 3.3 meter working width at 9 mph max working speed. It's not too bad. It's pretty sweet. So the thing is, it has this cover on it whenever it's not being used. So like, we go in here, you can see there's no cover because it's hooked up. But if I hop in here and I unhook it, well, there it is. Hook back up to it, and then the cover goes off. That is one of the coolest things. I don't know if I've ever seen that before. At least with a cover on it, that's pretty darn cool. Let's turn everything on. Let's see, is there anything here? So we have lift. We can change up our, So we have soybeans, sugar beets, cotton, corn, all that good stuff. That's normal. I think the rest of this is for the tractor. Yeah. So that's it. That's what you get. Pretty standard stuff through here overall, but it is very nice looking. It works really, really good on the back of this Valtra. Is this the A series? Yeah, the A134 Brazil. Looks pretty good on there. Next new mod for all platforms, we have the timber framed shed. This is a really small timber frame shed, exactly as they were often constructed as field sheds to store hay or equipment back in the day, but it also fits quite well in the corner of a farm or basically anywhere where there's just a little bit of room. That's why the shed is really tiny. The shed has 2 doors, one on the front and one on the side. The building is the style and size roughly modeled after a real one. Price is going to be $6,500. Daily upkeep is $5 per day. It is fully seasons compatible, and it does have a snow roof, so snow will appear on the roof when it snows. Also, when it snows, more of the layer of snow will be on the roof the more it snows, which is pretty darn cool. Next, we have the Rabe MKE400. This is going to be a power harrow, and it prepares the soil for the next seed. It works just like a cultivator, except it is a power harrow. Changes the way it looks a little bit. I think they look really, really cool. Plus, you can hook up things to the back design, yes or no. So if you add that design, you're gonna get your pass-through. You're gonna get everything that you need to run maybe a 4-meter seeder on the back. Amazon's got a few in-game. So you can run other machines on the back of this if you wish, which is pretty sweet. This is going to require 95 horsepower, is a 4-meter working width at 9 mph. And again, you can add that extra hitch on the back. That's gonna cost you $1,000. Overall, $16,000 for what you see here. And your last new mod for all platforms today is gonna be Seasons Geo Brazil SC. This is tropical weather and it is great for growing sugarcane. So if you're playing on a Estancia La Pacho, this is going to be perfect. Weather data for this Seasons Geo comes from around Santa Catarina, Brazil. Very cool. This is by Adams Kong. Also, they have a YouTube channel. Go check them out. They do things similar to the way I do things here on the channel with a couple variations. Check them out. Really, really good YouTuber. And making her way into mod updates for all platforms today. We've only got one of them. It is for the Lizard Granos, and this is going to be changelog 1.1. New tire options. So we have Lizard and Michelin. And in Michelin, we can do a wide tire or big tire. I love that. Of course, Lizard is your standard tire that we've had. And they've also added the option to increase the capacity, taking it from the Lizard Granos 10500 up to the 12,000. Now, if you guys are on PC, yes, you do have this. However, we have the same mod, but in the branded version, the Ventudo Granos of 10500. So if you are on PC, you could just stick with this and be fine. But as I'm on PC, you can have both if you wish. And I want to say thank you to the modder for giving us that opportunity. if I was using this in a Let's Play, I would probably use this version, the Lizard Granos 10500, because it's something that everyone can have. So thank you, Kanta Komigo Modding, for giving us all that option. Changing speed and moving over to PC and Mac only mods today, we got seven new. First up, we have the Ryland Grain Silo. This is by Louder and Yudnorby. This is going to cost you $120,000. Capacity is 150,000 liters of wheat, barley, canola, corn, oats, sunflower, and soybeans. Daily upkeep is going to be $36 per day, and it is a very factory-looking mod. I really, really like this. This is definitely top-notch. From Green Bell, we have the Northern Coast Sheds. These are placeable sheds from the Northern Coast or other maps for whatever you want to put them on. Warning, you will need the Place Anywhere mod for the straw harvest yard. So do keep that in mind. Next new mod for PC and Mac players is the Kotek FE108 Silage Fork. This is going to hold 3,900 liters of any of your chaff products. So whether it be manure, whether it be grass, chaff in general, anything like that, you are good to go with 3,900 liters of it. Now, we do have some things that we could change. So first off, main color, we have the rifle black, and we have, I'm not even going to try and say that one, I actually don't know what that's changing. I do know what that's changing. So this is going to be either a diamond plate on the very top section or a steel or aluminum look. So whatever look you like to go for, there you go. And then this is going to change up the bottom. So you have a red, you have a steel metal, and then you have chrome. Reflectors? No. Yes. So this is going to add reflectors here on the edges. You've got one on the left and one on the right. And then attacher type. We have front loader, wheel loader, telehandler, and then back to front loader. So no skid steer on this one. Probably 3,900 liters is probably a little bit much for a skid steer anyway. Very cool, very detailed and amazing looking mod right here. Next up, we have the Real Time mod by 3DMX Modding. This script synchronizes real time with PC time with the game time. So fast forward will be deactivated. For example, it is currently 9:01 a.m. at the time of recording this video, at least for me here on the East Coast of the United States. Therefore, this mod would make my in-game time 9:01 a.m. You cannot fast forward, you cannot stop time. All of that has been disabled. It is what it is. I think this is really neat. This is going to give you guys some very cool, realistic, and time-sensitive gameplay, perhaps. Maybe you want to play daytime. You just want to wake up and live the life of a real farmer. Maybe you've got like a week off of work or school, or you know, you just want to play Farming Simulator, man. I just want to play. Well, you can do that. With this mod, I think this gives you the opportunity to live the life of a farmer in the game. Maybe slow down just a little bit. This is cool. Next, we have the Gruber SM Pack. Now, this is going to come with two versions. We have the 350T and the 450T. Both of these are going to be manure spreaders only. The smaller version is going to hold 5,000. Large version, 6,000. 60 horsepower required for both. 9 meter working width at 12 miles per hour. It's a pretty standard. How about this? Let's customize. Extension, we have small extension. We have big extension, which is going to bring us from 3,500 up to that 5,000 mark. We've also got a different extensions here as well. It says metal extension. That is a wood extension. Oh, that's a wood extension. Okay, well, never mind. There you go. So you got multiple extensions on there, so you can make this look however you like. Wheel brands, we do have Trelleborg, Midas, we have Vredstein, and back to Trelleborg. And Trelleborg, we got a couple through here. We have the 380s, the 480s, we have the 500s, and then our 404-500s, rather. Very beautiful tire. Then back down to the 380s. In Midas, no change. In Vredstein, we have the 380 55R17s. We have the 480. So back and forth between 380 and the 480. Very cool. I'm glad that we get those options. Similar stuff here. I'm going to assume 4,500 liters or 6,000 with the extension. Extensions look exactly the same. Wheel brands, yeah, those are all the same. Trelleborg, Midas, Bridgestone, yeah, all the same. Very cool. I like the consistency and the cohesiveness between the two mods. Beautiful mods here. I think they look great, and it's going to be perfect for smaller farms where you want to get out there and do some manure spreading. Your next to last new mod for PC and Mac players today is going to be the Nefes 93341 or 93341, however you want to say it. I don't know how to say it. This right here is going to be an auto load bale trailer, I believe doing square bales, and holds 22 of them. Through here we have design color, and this is going to be either blue or gray. As a matter of fact, let's go ahead, let's get one of those. Let's go in here, let's get ourselves a truck. Doesn't need to be anything fancy. Go through here, what do we get? Blue. Yeah, we'll just go with a black truck. Black trucks always look good. Lizard tires, because why not? Let's hook up, let's turn a little bit of sound on, and let's test this and see, is this auto load, or is this just going to be something where we need to load up on the back? Oh, please, can I have it? Got it. Let's turn this on. Let's see, operating position. We are in operating position. Let's go over here. Let's put an unhealthy amount of bales. That should be about where we want it. Nice. Hey-o. All right, now let's just drive by and pick them up. Hey, there you go. So it looks like it works. So that's a good thing. Should go. Yep, and it did. And we have our 22 square bales. Now, how do we offload them? Let's take a look and see. So we want to unload bales. I'm actually unable to move them. So these bales, it looks like the platform, reload them. Okay, so you can see the left side here is going down. So we've got that all the way down. Right side, we've got the right side down. Looks like we can lower the back as well. Okay, so that's down. Good. It's really, really slow. And then same thing here, the controls are backwards on the rear one, but that's okay. So you go up to go down, but it still doesn't look like we can actually move them off the trailer. So can we auto load them on? Yes. Can we auto load them off? No. You will have to pick them up and do like that. Not a problem, is what it is. And your last new mod for PC and Mac players today is actually a mod that we got yesterday. However, this offers more compatibility and more customization options. So this is the Fent Tygo Pack. Of course, it's available for all platforms. However, there is a version that we got today that is PC only. I went into the files and double checked, make sure that I wasn't going crazy. I wasn't, thank goodness. If you are on PC, this is the only version that you can download now. So if you did not get yesterday's version without these extra features, well, you're not going to be able to get it, but don't worry, it's okay. This is going to hold all your standard normal crops that you would normally put in here. So forages of all kinds. And with this one, we actually get some extra tire options. So we get the BKTs and the Vredsteins as well. So in the BKTs, we have a standard tire and a wide tire, and the Vredstein, we have a standard tire and a wide tire. So we have those in there as well. Pretty cool. Interesting that we got a completely new version the day after we got this one, but hey, I'm not a modder. I'm just the guy that is confused. Hell, let's move on. And moving into mod updates for PC and Mac players today, we've only got one of them, and this is our last mod today. This is going to be Maze Plus by the Alien Paul and Model Liger. This is the Farming Agency. Ah, yeah, we got some really cool stuff with the Farming Agency coming up later this week. Make sure you guys stay tuned. But for now, Maze Plus update version 1.4. Global tedder script has been added, and global mower conditioner script has been added, along with several bug fixes. And with that, that is going to be the end of today's mod video. I hope you've enjoyed. If you did, make sure you drop a like on it, get subscribed to the channel if you're new, and join the GoHam fam. Make sure you turn your notification bells on as well, so that you never miss daily Farming Simulator videos here on the channel. We will have Farm Sim news coming out very soon. Mods dropped super early today, so we went with those first. Check the first pinned comment down below, and you'll be able to find a link to Farm Sim news there. If it says Farm Sim news link coming soon, just means I haven't done it yet. That's all. All being said, I hope you guys have a great day. We'll see you later. Peace.